Welcome all to my YouTube channel TechEJ, where we discuss different microcontroller related circuits, its Proteus design, and observe the simulation output. So please do subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell icon to get notifications about my newly uploaded videos. For any query, you can reach out to me through a mail. In this video, we are going to discuss automatic room temperature control using PIC-ATINIA-4550. Let's understand our system. We want to design a system which will maintain the temperature of a room between 25 degrees Celsius to the 30 degrees Celsius. For that purpose, we have designed a microcontroller-based system consisting of a LM35, fan or AC, heater and LCD. Our system first of all read room temperature by using LM35. If the temperature is above 30 degrees Celsius, it will start fan or AC to bring down the temperature of a room between 25 degrees Celsius to the 30 degrees Celsius. If temperature of a room goes below 25 degrees Celsius, our system will start the heater so that the temperature of a room will bring above the 25 degrees Celsius. And if the temperature of a room is in between 25 degrees Celsius to the 30 degrees Celsius, our system will keep both fan and heater off. All this information will be displayed on a LCD. So let's go to the Proteus design and observe the simulation output. So this is the Proteus design of our system, where microcontroller PIC-ATINIA-4550 has interfaced with the four components. First one is the LM35 temperature sensor, second one is the fan, then heater and LCD. Let's understand the interfacing of these components with PIC microcontroller. LM35 temperature sensor reads the temperature data and generates the output in a millivolt. We know that for LM35, for every 1 degree Celsius change in temperature, the output has been changed by 10 millivolt. So this output data in terms of millivolt has been given as the input of a PIC microcontroller through the ADC channel number 7, which will read this data in the form of millivolt, convert it into the temperature data and send it to the LCD. As well as that temperature data has been used to turn on fan and heater. The second component is the fan, which is connected to the port D, pin number 4, through the relay and transistor circuit. Now, one terminal of relay is connected to the supply, whereas another terminal of relay is connected to the ground. Whenever transistor is on, it is acting as a short circuit and ground has been directly connected to the second terminal of a relay and relay will turn on. As soon as the relay turns on, the fan will be connected to the ground through this switch and fan will start rotating, and whenever this transistor is off, it is acting as an open circuit so that second terminal of relay is not connected to the ground and relay is in a off condition. When relay is off, our fan also remains off as its second terminal is not connected to the ground. Similarly, we have interfaced the heater with the PIC-ATINIA-4550 through the port D, pin number 0, using the relay and transistor circuit. It's working also same as that of the fan circuit, where the transistor is acting as a switch which will turn on and off relay, and whenever relay is on, the heater will become on, and whenever relay is off, the heater will be off. Now at the input of both the relays, we can observe a diode, which is a freewheeling diode. And lastly, we have interfaced the LCD with the PIC-ATINIA-4550. The 8 data lines of LCD has been connected to the port B of PIC-ATINIA-4550, whereas RS of LCD is connected to the port C, pin number 0. Enable of LCD is connected to the port C, pin number 1, that is RC0 and RC1. Whereas RW has been connected to the ground, because we are going to write the data to the LCD, so RW remains 0. Let's load the hex file and observe the simulation result. And start the simulation. When we start the simulation, it will initialize the LCD and display the initialization value. On the LCD, on the first line, we have displayed the temperature value. Initially, it will show 0 degrees Celsius. Whereas on the second line of LCD, it will display the status of fan and heater. Initially, both are off. Now, if we observe, the temperature of LM35 is 31 degrees Celsius, which is larger than 30 degrees Celsius. Hence, it will start the fan and show the status fan on and heater off on a LCD. If we reduce the temperature below 30 degrees Celsius, let's observe. Suppose I will set the temperature 27 degrees Celsius. As temperature goes in between the range of 25 degrees Celsius to the 30 degrees Celsius, it will make both heater and fan off and accordingly display the status of heater and fan on a LCD. Now, if you reduce the temperature below 25 degrees Celsius, suppose if I set the temperature 23 degrees Celsius, as soon as temperature goes below 25 degrees Celsius, it will turn on heater and keep the fan off. And accordingly, it will display the status on a LCD. Again, as temperature goes above 25 degrees Celsius, both fan and heater are off. And as I take temperature above 30 degrees Celsius, the fan will start. So this is all about automatic room temperature control using PKTINIA 4550. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you.